Goodwill Community Foundation, creating opportunities for a better life.
Everyone has their own way of preparing for a presentation. What do you plan to say? How long will the presentation last? The first thing I do when I'm ready to rehearse is go to the slideshow tab. Not to run a slideshow, but to work on my timing, using the Rehearse Timings command. This mode lets you practice your presentation while recording the amount of time it takes to deliver each slide. See the little toolbar in the upper left corner? These timings can actually be used to run your presentation automatically, so you can focus on your talking points instead of advancing the slides. While in rehearsal mode, just click the Next button to move to the next slide, or use the right arrow key on your keyboard. If you need more than one try to get a timing right, you can take a break using the pause button, and then resume the recording when you're ready. To re-record the timing on the current slide, just click the Repeat button, and it'll reset the clock. Once again, click Resume when you're ready to start recording again. Let's skip ahead to the end of the slideshow. Imagine I've just spent this time practicing my entire presentation. To return to PowerPoint, I'm going to press Escape on my keyboard, and then Yes to save the timings from this rehearsal. To view your timings, navigate to Slide Sorter View, and if we zoom in, you can see them listed under each slide. Now when I give my presentation, I can let the slides run automatically without having to advance them myself. That gives me an idea. Why don't we start over, and this time make a copy of the presentation that people can view on their own, with slide timings and narration. It's possible with the Record Slideshow feature. All you need is a microphone for your computer. Open the menu here, and you can record from your current slide or from the beginning if you're just getting started. That's what we're going to choose. Check what you want to include. For me, timings and narration because I do have a mic. Then click Start Recording and be ready to perform your presentation as soon as it begins. Make sure to speak clearly into the mic if you're recording narration. When you're ready to move to the next slide, click Next or use the arrow key just like before. The mouse is designed to be invisible in the final recording, so if you want to point something out, you'll need to do it using something the viewer can see, the laser pointer. Just hold Control on your keyboard, then click and hold your mouse anywhere on the slide. When you're finished, press the Escape key. Now my timings and narration are part of the presentation. Any slide that has narration will be marked with a tiny speaker icon in the bottom right corner. If you change your mind and want to remove any timings or narration, just open the Record Slideshow menu, then mouse over the Clear option. You can erase timings and narration from the current slide or all slides. I'm going to give this another go when I have all my talking points together, but I'm not too worried. With the ability to rehearse and record, I know I'll be ready to deliver my presentation, whether it's to a live audience or to the viewer's personal computer.